The Camila Cabello solo era has arrived with the release of not just one, but two new songs last weekend. The backstory to one of those songs, Crying in the Club, is now coming to light. So let's take a look back to a journey that first began back in May of 2016. Fifth Harmony was busy promoting their sophomore album 727, and in between press stops, Camila hit the studio to record with producer Benny Blanco. Both wound up contributing to the song Love Incredible of her Cashmere Cat, with Blanco leaving the sessions impressed by Camila's work ethic. She's unbelievably driven. Anytime we're in the studio, she's like, am I working hard enough? Fast forward now to December 19th, 2016. Fifth Harmony, as we've known them, is no more. According to a statement from the group's official Twitter account, representatives for Camila Cabello informed the other four members overnight that the Bad Things singer will be departing Fifth Harmony, effective immediately. Our happiness is our own responsibility, writes Cabello in a message following news breaking that she had decided to leave the group that made her famous. And after years of writing during her free time, the 19-year-old begins penning songs for her eventual debut. A couple months pass, and now Blanco is writing a demo with Sia in LA when inspiration strikes the Australian songwriter. Sia was on her way to the bathroom and goes, oh my God, I have a really good idea for a song. When she came back, we did the song in 20 minutes. That song was Crying in the Club, and the next month, Blanco offered it to Cabello. Camila would rewrite the song's bridge and quickly record the track. It had a message about healing through the power of music, Cabello explains. That theme was a key part of what I wanted for my album. That now takes us to present day, or should I say, May 19th, and the release of Crying worldwide. In the weeks since its release, the song has already accumulated over 11.5 million streams on Spotify alone, and Camila performed the song at the 2017 Billboard Music Awards. So what do you think of Crying in the Club? I want your official review down in the comments of this one, and you can also check out the article covering this very story up on billboard.com right now if you're looking to learn a little bit more about this one. And until next time for Billboard News, I'm Kevin Kenney.